Religion is supposed to unite human beings. It's not supposed to divide us. And if it's divisive, it's not religion from God. It's something else. And I think people should really think deeply about that. Imam Ali radiallahu anhu said an amazing thing. He said, "Al-jama'atu ma'a al-kudura khayrun min al-furqa ma'a al-safwa." That the group with its impurities is better than sectarianism with its purity. That really think deeply about that. You know, that religion is here to unite us. It's not here to divide us. And if it's dividing us, it's not God's religion. It's something else. And so it's a great blessing to be in a place just where you feel comfortable. And you don't have to worry about somebody telling you, you're not doing this right. You know, and if somebody did correct you, it would be out of love and not out of this arrogant, pious, self-righteous attitude of superiority. And so this type of religion, we have to fight it, really, because it's killing the soul of the Muslims. And it's all over the place now. You know, these memes, to use Dawkins, I don't really like to use Dawkins' terms, but you know, he came up with the idea of memes that are like viruses, intellectual viruses. And we've got these intellectual viruses that are making our community sick. And we really need to, you know, wash our hands, you know, in order not to get, right? You wash your hands. We have to clean our, you know, really purify ourselves just to make sure we're not infected by these attitudes and this arrogance and these things that are so antithetical to the Muslim spirit. So that's my hope, really, that you, you know, just the experience that you've had here, that you take that back to your communities. مَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لِتَشْقَى. We didn't reveal this Qur'an for you to be miserable. I mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that to His Prophet. We did not reveal this Qur'an for you to be miserable. The mukhalifa, the understanding, the reverse understanding is أَنزَلْنَاهُ لِتَسْعَد. We revealed this book to make you happy. So if Islam is not making you happy, something's wrong with your Islam. And if you're making other people unhappy, you know, woe unto you for driving people out of Islam. You know, and there are people that are driving people away from Islam. And this is, we're in the end game, people. I mean, if you don't see that, I don't know what planet you're living on. We're coming down to end game. Maybe it's 100 years from now. Maybe it's 200. I don't know. Those things are in the knowledge of God. But our Prophet said, "Bu'ithtu wa sa'aka hatayni." I was sent and the end of time are like these two. And he put his wusta and his sababa together. Just like that. "Bu'ithtu ana wa sa'atayn wa sa'atu kahatayni." I was sent and the hour is like this. That was 1400 years ago. And in terms of how long humans have been here, it's not a long time, 1400 years. It's just a flash. So this is a time for people to have a lot of rahab, you know, just expansiveness in their hearts for people. Baza, baza. I wish I could quote it in Persian, but you know, we're in the city of Mawlana Jalaluddin, and he has a beautiful qasida which is in the entrance to his maqam. Come, come again, come. You know, whatever you've done, this isn't a caravan of despair. You know, sinner, if you've broken your vow 1,000 times, just come back. The door's open. And anybody that closes it is a shaitan. You know, and there's people closing that door on people that need to hear that message. You know, because this world can defile you. But no matter how defiled you are, Allah's door is open. No matter what's happened to you, Allah's door is open. I mean, we have testimony in the Hadith to a mass murderer who was given Tawbah. He killed 100 people and he was given Tawbah. this door is open, and people, we need to open it up and let people come in with all their faults and all their flaws and all their dysfunctionalities and all their problems. Just open the door and let people come in. Hudhayf al-Yamani, he said, the end of time won't come until the Muslims are like a big rock in a river. They don't drink from it and they don't let other people drink from it. And he said, and the one seeing it is not like the one telling it. So don't be like that rock that doesn't let the river flow and let people drink from it. This people need, they're dying of thirst out there. They're dying of spiritual thirst. Really, if we had in America spiritual disability as a possibility to get insurance and not go to work, we wouldn't have anybody working anymore. There are people are on antidepressants, they're on anxiolytics. They're really not well. People aren't well. And they need, the reason they're not well is because they're not fulfilling their purpose. You cannot be well unless you're being human. We were created to be human, and the way that we are human is to surrender. It's just to surrender, to give up, to not fight Allah. And that's rida, it's contentment, it's when the qadr comes, mashallah, qadr Allah, masha'an fa'al. I was in a taxi in Saudi Arabia.